Make sure you know ass about us, man. Niggas saving money in America, baby.
Oh my goodness, glory. Hey man, YouTube, what's going on? This is the thrift god back at you guys. Hey, what's up, sir? Anyways, man, that's the homie right there yelling at me. I would turn the camera on him, but I'm like disallowed to do that. But I'm outside of a Goodwill right now, and basically, man, I am a thrift addict and my urges are flaring up, and I'm not trying to recover whatsoever. I'm trying to find that flame. So without further ado, let's jump in this first trill wheel and see what's good with it, people. Let go. Oh God, people. All right, man. So I actually have a new mission in this video, and I found two pairs of dad shoes that are in my size in Goodwill. So you got the New Balance. I don't know what numbers these are. The 654321s, son. So you have the New Balances right here, my size, and these Fila Flamers. These are 10 bucks. The New Balances are 10 bucks. And I think today, instead of maybe just doing a trip to the thrift, I'm gonna do a custom thrifted dad shoe challenge. So just people we're starting with, and we'll see what we end up doing with these dad shoes. Both my size, you guys know, they trending right now. So I'm gonna try and transform these suckas right here, right now. Let's go. All right, class, so here are the shoes, and the first thing we need to do is get rid of that booty scent. So I have this Fresh Fogger that I think I got at Finish Line or Champs. I don't know, I'm not brand loyal at all. You guys already know what time it is. So I just sprayed that all up deep inside the shoes to remove any bacteria. And then I also removed these white Anaconda cocaine laces. And once those were ripped out, I had to clean the shoes with that Dawn dish soap. This is what I use. I just stirred up with a toothbrush with some water and then scrubbed the whole thing down with some fingernail cleaner car brush, bro. And yes, it is a red Porsche 911. I'm balling. So then the next thing I had to do was prep the surface of the shoe and remove the clear coat of leather protective paint that is on every pretty much pair of kicks that you guys will buy. So I just put on some nail polish remover on a cotton swab, and yes, bruh, I'll show you guys the cheapest way to do this. And then I just rub down the entire shoe with the cotton ball just to remove that clear coat and to get any scuffs or marks off the surface. And once that was done, the surface was looking prepped and ready to go for the paint job. So without further ado, we're gonna cut back to my beautiful glistening face.
Whoop! All right, so now that the preparatory process is complete, these shoes are looking clean and distinct. Maybe I should rock these as is. Psych, it is time to actually apply the paint. So you guys already know the paint I use for all my customization needs is Angelus Leather Acrylic Paint. And the link to all the painting supplies, any shoe restoration supplies, and brushes is in the description down below. So if you guys check out that link, it definitely will help your boy out. And if you need any supplies, it kills two birds with one stone. Speaking of stone, man, I came up with this stoned ass looking design in Photoshop for how I'm gonna color block this shoe, and I did like the way it turned out digitally, and now it is time to actually take the digital design and put it in the physical realm and apply the paint to the shoe. So without further ado, let's amass this array of colors and add them onto the kick.
Bam, and here is the array. You got red, you have purple lilac, red chili red, double yellows, and turquoise and green. So this is pretty much all the colors I'm gonna use. But without further ado, let's start applying these on the surface. So the first two colors I'm going to add on the shoe are red and chili red. Now I decided to mix these two in just kind of a random ratio because the red in and of itself is usually too strong. So I wanted just a mixture with a little bit of a more bright kind of red orange color. So I added about halfway chili red and then the other half was red. Then I stirred up with the back of my paintbrush and then I started blocking out the surface. So I chose red first because red is the most predominant color that is going to be on the shoe. So I just figured for my own sanity, I had to get these nurse looking New Balances looking right inside with the custom. So I added a thin coat of red paint right in the center and I actually add about four coats of this red. And I also hit the nice blocking on the back with the red as well. So I had the red in the middle, I'm throwing some red on the back, and then I also threw some red on the front with the toe cap. And once I had the toe cap complete, that is pretty much all there was for the red region of the shoe. And already the shoe was looking better, in my humble opinion. You guys already know what it is. A little color goes a long way. Was good. All right, so color number two is going to be green. So I'm mixing turquoise with green and I'm adding a nice hit of that lemon yellow into the paint combo as well. I just needed this green to stand out a little bit more. So that is the mixture I went with, again, back of the brush all day. So I started applying again the green on the back region, and this is the second biggest region, and that is why I was biased with this green paint. Now the green was actually a little bit different than the red in the way it reacted on the surface. I actually only needed to apply about 3 coats of paint for it to be fully on, even, and looking schmexy. So yeah, I like the bright green choice, and it already kind of had a Mexico World Cup type of vibe going on the shoe, so it definitely was cool. And that shit goes to show, like, anytime you customize a shoe, as soon as you start laying down the colors, you can take it any direction you possibly want. But the direction I want to take it is the same direction I drew up. So we're adding the blue next, which is a combo of blue and gift box blue. I don't use pure colors, kind of like a little art school thing. I like making unique colors, and this Smurf blue definitely was fire. So I had to go ahead and apply that. Now, one thing I did notice was the green paint was so dummy glossy, and as is this blue paint. And that is probably one of the worst aspects about Angelus paint when you buy it just straight up without a duller, is it usually comes out hella glossy because it has a protective surface integrated in the actual painting material. But it does make the shoe look like it's straight up patent leather, when in reality I want it to look a bit more flat. But I will attack that in a second. But for now, we're hitting the shoe with the yellow. So I attacked the toe cap with this piss colorway, aka the Big Bird color scheme. And when I applied the yellow, my eyes started popping out my head. I was like, yes, this is what I needed to take the shoe to the next level. So of course I threw some on the tongue, I threw some on the toe cap, and then I also threw some on the booty clap on the back of the shoe as well. Now, I didn't really paint the detailing of the shoe. I left it as is because I figured the gray with the gray of the outsole would look dope. So here's the shoe, and overall it is looking schmexy. So the next color I applied was like this lilac type of purple. I mixed purple with lilac, and it overall was looking dope in the meshing. So I pretty much threw on every color of the rainbow on this shoe just because I love rocking flamboyant bright colored clothes. So having a kick that can go with just about all of it is definitely quintessential to have in my wardrobe. So that's why I added the perp all up on the tongue and on the toe cap region. And right here, it almost is looking like a Bafsta. You know what I'm saying? Like, low key, this is like a Bafsta type of colorway. Not really what I was going for, but some shit just turns out that way. And then, of course, if I'm adding the rainbow, looking like Tekashi 69's hair, you know what I'm saying? Looking like a big bag of Skittles, I gotta throw on the orange on the back. Tangerine in this thing. And last but certainly not least, I just tied the shoe together with some black, which I attached all over the detailing of the shoe, and this kind of made the shoe look a bit more cartoonized. And again, low-key like a clown shoe, but hey, I fucks with it. It's my aesthetic, and that is what's dope about making any custom, is literally the world is yours. So I did the detailing on the end, and all along what were previously navy blue regions of the shoe did become blacked out. And overall, the shoe was looking extremely clean at this point, aside from the dummy level of gloss that is still just dripping all over the frame of this shoe. So now I have to handle that. And what I did was I applied some duller into the original colors, and I went back on the shoe and painted again. So yes, I was kind of working out the kinks of my mistakes, and I didn't know how glossy it would be initially when I mixed the colors together, but it was way too glossy. So from now on, I'm gonna add duller to just about every paint that isn't flat, because having the shoe look this glossy makes it low-key look a bit more customized and a bit cheaper, as opposed to looking like a professional paint job. And that's just my humble opinion. So I added 2 coats on the green and the blue, and right here, boom, it's looking flat, it's looking sexy, and that is what I desired. Now, I know a lot of you guys would freak the fuck out, so I am going to apply a matte finisher on the shoe. But the matte finishers that you guys purchased from Angelus really are not matte at all. They're just like, make the shoe hella glossy, man. And so I added some duller into the matte finisher, and then I applied it, and it pretty much honestly counteracted all the fucking like duller that I put in the paint, and just made the shoe even more glossy. So I don't know, I may have to look at different types of finishers or really put a lot more duller in the paint initially. But still, overall, it's not as glossy as it was originally, and it still looks sexy, and I pretty much like the way the shoe looks all together. Threw in some white laces and we was good to go. Now, when you compare the two shoes, oh my gosh, there is a world of difference, ladies and gentlemen. You got the nurse shoe originally with this crazy clown shoe. Woo! That's what I'm talking about. So yeah, man. I mean, the comparison is definitely worlds and worlds apart, and I overall was pretty stoked with the way I created this custom pair of kicks for my own preference and my own liking. But enough of my chit-chat. Let's get it back into an expert analysis with my beautiful, sparkling, glistening face. Let's get it, man. Love y'all.
All right, Charlie. So that is right, ladies and gentlemen. The shoes are complete. And looking at the differentiation between the two, I definitely feel like they have come a very long way from where they started off originally. Now, with this customization, I learned a lot of things. Number one, the importance of duller initially, because these shoes are still very glossy and saucy. Also, just a little slight critique of myself. I'm probably going to take these white laces out, but this honestly is like the only laces that I had laying around. And I just figured I'd get done with this customization tonight. And as you guys saw, man, I started in the daytime. And I just now got done with this shoe. It took about like 6 hours. But again, I was working out a lot of the kinks in the customization initially. And so, yeah, man, that just goes to show that you can low-key like Nike ID a thrifted fucking shoe for very cheap, even though it's New Balance and not Nike. But yeah, man, I wanted a pair with these bright-ass colors. I know these might not be everyone's style, and that's perfectly fine. But it just goes to show that you can pick up a pair of shoes for $10 and turn them into whatever the hell you want. It does take some time, some practice, some technique, but that's pretty much all there is to it when you're transforming some dad shoes in these streets. And honestly, guys, this isn't even the coolest New Balance silhouette. I have this silhouette right here that I honestly think would have been a lot better in terms of like a dad shoe aesthetic. However, these are what I found, so I figured I would stick with the initial pair that I copped. So yeah, man, this customization may be coming soon, and I'm just gonna tell you guys that I got some fire cooking in the dad shoe market, so stay tuned. But yeah, man, it's late as fuck. I'm gonna finish doing this shoe tonight, and hopefully we'll have these on feet in a future video. But if you guys enjoyed, like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on the bell for notifications, and I will catch you guys next time. Live the dream and eat that ice cream. I'm locked and loaded, fully toted, and I'm gone. Killing these songs, leaving them bloody like Pyrus do. And I'm in it to win it, so I'm somebody that you should get used to.